Myself, Pawan Kadam, Assistant Professor and Head, Department of Chemistry, Sri Venkatesh Arts Commerce and Science College, Devgaraja. Friends, today we will discuss here the practical from chemistry. So this practical is for BSc third year, semester fifth student, as per the syllabus of Sant Gadge Baba, Amravati University, Amravati. So friends, today we will see the practical of preparation of tetraamine copper 2 sulfate. So I will now here demonstrate the practical, that is preparation of tetraamine copper 2 sulfate. So copper tetraamine sulfate, these are the blue colored crystals. So that are the dark blue colored crystals are there. Now this is a structure of copper tetraamine sulfate complex. So now we will see the demonstration how we will prepare this tetraamine copper sulfate. Now first is the introduction. The tetraamine copper sulfate is inorganic compound, that is a coordination complex having the formula CuNH3O4SO4. So that is the formula of tetraamine copper sulfate. So this is a dark blue color solid compound having the odor of ammonia. So it has the some faint odor of ammonia. It is closely related with the scissors reagent, which is used for the production of cellulose fibers in the production of rayon. It is used in the print fabrics, used as a pesticide, used to make other copper compounds like copper nanopowder. These are the some uses of this complex. Now we will see the theory. So tetraamine copper 2 sulfate is prepared by adding concentrated ammonia to the copper sulfate solution. The reaction. So the reaction is two step. In the first step, the ammonia reacts with copper sulfate solution to form faint blue color compound copper hydroxide. And in the next step, when we add the excess of ammonia, this copper hydroxide is converted into the dark blue colored solution, that is the copper tetraamine copper sulfate complex. Now the reaction, so you can observe here, so there is a copper sulfate that is in the hydrated form, pentahydrated, and when we add concentrated ammonia, the reaction is like this and we will get the product, that is the tetraamine copper sulfate. So this is the reaction. Now friends, we will see the requirement for this practical. We require the apparatus like conical flask, beaker, funnel, measuring cylinder, stirrer, etc. And now we will see the chemicals. The chemicals required for this practicals, they are copper sulfate 1 gram, liquor ammonia 5 ml, there is a liquor ammonia 5 ml, ethanol 5 ml and distilled water 5 ml. So these are the requirements for this practical. Now we will see the procedure of this practical. So how to do the practical. Now we will see the demonstration of preparation of tetraamine copper 2 sulfate complex. For this we require 1 gram of copper sulfate. So take this copper sulfate and in a beaker and add 5 ml of distilled water. Add 5 ml of distilled water and dissolve copper sulfate to form clear solution. So you can observe here, clear solution is formed of copper sulfate. Now take this copper sulfate solution in a conical flask this copper sulfate solution, now we will add the liquid ammonia, the concentrated ammonia 5 ml. So here when we add the liquid ammonia, you can observe here first faint blue colored compound is copper hydroxide is formed, and when we add excess of ammonia, now the solution becomes dark blue in color. The complex tetramine copper sulfate complex is formed. That is a copper tetramine copper sulfate complex. So there is a dark blue colored solution is formed. Now we have to add ethanol, 5 ml of ethanol. Add 5 ml of ethanol to this solution, and we can observe here blue colored precipitates will form. So here you can observe blue colored compound precipitate is formed. Now heat this complex in a water bath at 60 to 70 degrees Celsius for 15 to 20 minutes. So just heat it on a water bath like this. So don't touch the bottom of conical pass to the bottom of that water bath. So just it should be suspended in the water and heat it for 15 to 20 minutes. So heat it on a water bath at 60 to 70 degrees Celsius for 15 to 20 minutes. So after completion of heating, allow it to stand here for 5 to 10 minutes, that is allow it to cool down, and then you can observe here the crystals . So allow it to cool, and you can observe here the crystals, they are formed. Now the next step is filter. You can observe here a blue colored crystals are formed of tetramine copper 2 sulfate to dry this compound and recrystallize from ethene. Thank you friends for watching my video.